Greetings, everyone. I'm a raging mocha lover, and thank you for rejoining me here back in Kaiserreich. So, as one of the comments said from the last video, take a break, calm down a little bit, and I definitely have done that. I do apologize for the amount of rage I had last episodes, but apparently some of you guys actually kind of enjoyed it. Some of you guys didn't, but it is what it is. My apologies, I'm only human. But we've got quite a few comments before we continue. Now, I played off just a little bit, or played just a little bit after yesterday's episode, because I wanted to see what would happen once these guys kept attacking me. And, well, once they started attacking me, I've cut them off. Actually, we haven't cut them off completely yet. And, let's see, where are you guys headed to? Horses, go this way. I'd like you guys to go up to there and cut off the ports, if possible. Or at least, maybe even get to Jerusalem or Kurdus y Serif. But before that time go on, actually, we could risk it. I could risk getting encircled here and probably try to get to Port Said and maybe the Suez. Maybe, I don't know. Here are the casualties, anyways. We've lost 216,000. Well, we've killed off, well, I'd say probably a good 250,000. But before we let time go on, the Iranians, or the Persians, are still attacking us, and it's a little concerning, I would say. So I merged some armies together, and I'm pushing soldiers back up. Let's see, oh, the comments. So, if we want to commit things called war crimes, we need... Soldiers need weapons. So yeah, soldiers need weapons. We're doing a little bit better on weapons now, since from yesterday's video. Let's see... And actually, it helps if you don't attack. So, yep. To do that, it definitely helps out. We get about 107 guns a day. That's pretty good, so... Let's see. So it recommends we do an intelligence agency stuff to get to put down anti-partisan stuff. Yeah, I totally hear you. We've already started doing that down here. I think it was the Hejaz. Or no, Syria. Syria. We got that going as well. So it recommends we actually make our military police division huge. So that way the percentages work more in our favor. So we might as well go ahead and try that. Actually, camel. You actually lose speed with camels, which is kind of disappointing. They actually weigh a little bit more. But they do take less guns, so I guess that doesn't make any sense. But okay, sure, why not? So, you know what? Because of the percentages, we shall make some really thick garrison templates. And this might just save us some equipment, manpower, even though manpower isn't really a big issue right now. Now, I don't know, like, after all this Middle Eastern stuff is done, I suppose we can eventually go to war with whoever we really want and justify people, but... I don't know. We'll see what happens. Hopefully that will do okay first right there. And let's see, other comments. I could have granted Yemen independence first and then focus on everyone else. Well, I guess technically we could have. I'm not sure if we would be able to really get, like, a war goal against them later on. So that would have been interesting. Yeah, there's a lot of mountains and deserts, and especially mountains and hills down here, and urban territories, which makes it even harder to attack. Let's see. Yeah, I said soldiers to attack without guns. Calm down a little bit more. Also, I always forget to do puppet decisions. So, yeah. We have no subjects, though. So, well, that's a great idea. We can't quite do that since we don't have anybody here. And someone said the Ottomans are destined to fail in Kaiserreich. I guess. I have no idea. So, it is what it is. But regardless, because the Egyptians attacked so hard, we were able to split these guys up, which is very, very nice for us. And hopefully the cavalry can break over Port Said and get to Alexandria. That'd be kind of good. Oh, you guys. I'm going to have you guys focus up here, really. I mean, there's really no point. I want to crush the Syrians as fast as possible, so... Go do that. Take the ports away so that the Egyptian divisions here get struggle quite a bit. Where are you headed to? You know what? Screw it. You guys can go that way, too. These horses can do whatever we need to do. You go just take the capital. Oh, they found... They knew that I was attacking them. I really should stop attacking, but I'm going to keep these guys attacking anyways, because we can go there, and then we can go right there. Because we want to get at least the Suez. Keep them in place. As long as they can't move, that's good. Oh. Have we just cut them off from the ports? Almost. You guys hanging out? You might as well help out then. Not bad. I mean, it's still green for now, which is good and all, but still. You help break through them. If you can get over here quickly, that'd be good. I'm literally just attacking just so that we can push over and make sure that they do not stop us. That's probably pretty darn important. Let's see. Refit our dreadnoughts. Not bad. Black Sea stuff. Let's grab some of this. Why not? On the coast of the Sea of Marmara lies the town of Gulkuk and the nearby naval base of the same name. The naval base needs to be paired with a new dry dock and supporting facilities in order for us to build and refit better ships. Very good. At least our ships are still doing stuff, which is kind of nice. Come on, cavalry and tanks. Break on over. Oh, no, 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 no. Come on, you guys got this. You guys got this. There we go. Get the Suez. Do not let them in. Get the Suez. Get this. Oh, we got the Suez. Oh, yeah. That's nice. Help keep them in place for now. Let you guys get up here, too. And come on. Can we get them off from the port? That'd be great. At this point, I don't think this... Oh, we cut them off completely. Nice. Nice. I know attacking without guns is probably a really bad idea, but the more attacks we do, the less they can do themselves. So you guys are just going to go there, and then you're going to go north if you can. You guys are going to help attack and still push over that way if we can, hopefully. It definitely helps to attack sometimes. Oh, you guys don't attack anymore. Who's actually... What army is this? So you guys are doing all this. That's fine. Let's make sure we set this up a little bit better. Let these guys continue attacking. We'll probably recall these soldiers around, maybe... You guys, we don't have enough, we really don't have enough divisions over here. That's okay. Let's see. Where are my cavalry divisions at? There you go. I want all of you guys over here. As long as we broke over and we can hold, that's all that really matters. You guys hold as well. Don't attack anymore. Just hold. Actually, just in case it attacks Suez, we're going to stay here for now. Let the cavalry come down. I think we'll do okay. I think we'll do okay. I don't want to attack anymore because since we don't have any guns. We do have 53 political power. Oh, not bad. You guys... Ooh, man, that's not good. Ooh, actually, you guys come here. We can delete that division. Keep attacking then there. Improved computer machine. Very good, very good. Let's see. Ooh, no. That stuff is pretty good. Military boosts we're doing well on. Field hospitals. Do we even... We don't have enough support equipment for anything here. Let's see. None? We could probably increase centralization if we wanted to. Are there any, like, areas that need... Oh, this area needs it. There you go. Oh, probably help... Diyarbakir? If they want to come in, so we can beat them once this group is... Oh, this is nice. Once these guys are gone. Just make sure they don't go to the sea. Hold on, guys. You don't need to attack anymore. Please don't attack. Honestly, all of you guys should just be focusing down here. But we'll split off a few soldiers to take out these guys down here, too, so... It'll be alright. You guys help out if you want to really move up. That's fine with me. I don't really care. Good, good, good. Get these guys back here. That's fine. These guys are actually really weak as well. Let's see. They have still plenty of divisions. Yeah, 15 to 20 to 26. Plenty of manpower. Ooh, and let's make sure we do this as well. I should probably pay a little bit more attention to the front over here, but oh well. There we go. That's better. Ah, better, 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 better. We're making some radar. We've got the Greeks up there we got to deal with. Overall, I think we're doing okay now. The worst, I think, hopefully, has already come to pass, so. I really want to help attack, so be it. Don't do that. We have minus 15,000 guns still. Not bueno. Oh, guys, go ahead and stop doing that. You're a bit crazy. Hey, we got them. Nice. So keep these guys there. Keep our guys here for now. And we're holding. So let's spend some time and... Well, keep doing our land auction, but also spend some time to, I guess, do nuclear research. Why not? Get some more guns. Just build ourselves up a little bit more and more. Oh, destroyer. There you go. Why not? Does anyone here have upgrades or good upgrades? I want you to get not those upgrades, though. And that's not bad. We've got to wait maybe a little bit longer. That's fine. So we'll wait. Put down more resistance. Sierra Leone. Oh, wait. Ooh. Yeah, you're the garrisons. Yeah, that's good. Yeah, those are the garrisons. Hejaz has a lot of resistance. Wow. But we got a lot of compliance there, too. That's not too bad. So then they're not suffering from supply issues. We're not suffering from too many issues, either. At least we got that little modifier that I complained about yesterday that gave us more political power, basically, and division attack and defense. So I suppose it could be much worse. I do want to integrate these guys a little bit more, though. What decisions do we have? Oh, we have those things. That's pretty normal. Construct some stuff. Kurdish land's looking pretty good. Cool. We could fortify Aleppo if we really wanted to, but we don't really need to right now. We could fortify this place. Baghdad actually would probably be a good place to fortify, but that's alright. And some dockyards. Expand this. Expand the Basra Harbor Project. Let's go monopolize the railway companies. We could Yeah, we could probably do that. Probably be pretty good now. The DDUM, or DDUM, or State Railways Administration, was founded after the war to take over the Entente Railway concessions and to finance the construction of further railroads across the empire. Nonetheless, many foreign concessions remain and various privately held tracts refuse integration. With the crisis, however, many of these companies are on the brink of bankruptcy, opening the way for unification. Awesome. Ooh, I don't want to spend that yet. I want to increase the centralization actually here. Ooh, actually, that's not too bad. We can lower that. None. Nice. There you go. Now they are a province. Oh, actually, you suffered from attrition. Nice. And what's going on over here? Fuel's looking not too bad. We're getting more and more. Hey, you're doing 100 guns a day. That's just so good. So good. We could do that. I don't want any more unrest, though. Actually, where would that unrest end up going? Cyprus, Beirut, yeah, Samson, Constantia. Oh, that would not be good. Well, whatever. Give us a few more days. Really flesh out our soldiers with more weapons. It's best to wait. It's best to wait. Anything else here? We do have Empire Japan clear one of the Dutch East Indies. Good luck, guys. Hey, you got a little bit of support companies. That's not bad. Cool. Tank Baru. You guys aren't too bad. We don't really need that division, though. Not really. You guys. Since we have the Army XP right now. What are we missing? Guns? Yeah, just guns. That's all it is. That's all it is. It's always guns. Yeah, Kingdom of Spain, join Entente. Good luck, guys. Good luck. You're going to need it. Compliance, or resistance, I should say, is not going up or down. How about compliance, though? 0.8. Does it go up or down? Well, it's not going up, but at least it's not going down. Beirut. Oh, we got a radar there. That's nice. Beirut's pretty much firmly under control now. It's nice. We can increase centralization and do that as well. Very bueno. Not bad. Look at that. 12,000 guns. 110 guns a day, roughly. Not bad at all. I'm surprised you guys stopped attacking as well. But hey, you know what? That just saves manpower for us. And hopefully no one else wants to really attack us. I kind of really want to do this, but no. No. Actually, if we do that, we basically can put down unrest in three different places. So, we could. Screw it, we're going to do it. Give me that political power. And get more consumer goods. That's pretty nice, too. Constantinople, very low. Nope. Beirut, was it? Very low. Nope. Low. None. I should have read where I was going to get affected more. Low. None. Is there places that have medium, maybe? Low. 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 Oh, there's medium. There you go. Let's lower that one, and we almost have enough for another one. None. I'm glad it's very low in a lot of these areas. That's good. Oh, yeah, that's high. Actually, that's not good. We gotta lower that. Just gotta give it a few more days. I mean, we could try another attack, but these guys are looking pretty weak. Artillery-wise, not too bad. What are we trying to make? More guns? That's always good. More guns, right? We'll buy one more thing from you guys. That'd be good. Ooh, monopolies. Companies. Don't mind if we do. Railroad Unification Act. The Diviet, or Devlet, Demerolori, Umum, Dorulugu, or State Railway Administration, was founded shortly after the war to take over the Entente-held railway concessions and to finance the construction of further railroads across the vast lands of the empire. Nonetheless, many foreign concessions remain in various privately held tracts, mainly in Anatolia. Refused integration into the DDY, with the Berlin Stock Exchange disaster, however, many of these companies are on the brink of bankruptcy as such, opening up the way for the complete unification of the Ottoman railroad network. Act 294 BN, nicknamed the Lightning Bolt Act, referencing the way railroads pursue inhospitable interior of our nation, plans to, in one fell swoop, abolish all non-government-held railway companies and to bring their assets together into the DDY. Haki Bahik, former mastermind behind the original creation of the DDY, has been recalled from the Austro-Hungarian Empire to oversee the process and further expansion of the network. From Circaxi to Baghdad. Or Baghdad. Baghdad. Eastern Anatolian Railway Project. Just like the Americans conquered the frontier through the Iron Beast of the Industrial Era, so as their government decreed the expansion of a rail and other roads into eastern Anatolia. Around these railroads would then be created a system of villages and towns inhabited by Turks or immigrants of both the Balkans and Caucasus to strengthen the hold of Constantia over their own frontier. Good idea. Jolly good idea. We could do low. I suppose we will. We have absolutely no unrest. Which I kind of like. But are there any other places that we need to integrate further first? It's very low down there. It's not bad. It's low. Oh, how about over here? Low? That's not bad. Low. We can't integrate these areas yet. Villa has... Oh, all these areas have to be a villa yet. Ooh, how about you guys? Ah, you're medium. There you go. Now you're low. That's good. How about over here? Anything? Anything? No, 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 no. It's oh, it's still pretty high down here in Hejaz. Can we do this? Yes, we can. Do that? Yes, we can. Well, maybe not. Oh, not yet. And we can do this again. There we go. Nice. Guns, are we below 10,000? Yes, we are. Oh, just give it a few days and we'll do great. Beautiful. Regular Shiite pilgrims, huh? Baghdad unrest will increase. Persia gets harsh protest. Yeah, do it. Why not? Now they're low, so I don't really care too much about that. The Rhodos. Oh, they're so high there. Oh, I didn't realize that. They've got a lot of people on the island there. Huh. Well, at least they stopped attacking. I mean, they must have lost a lot of guys. Yeah, 400,000. Holy cow. All right, so we could have tried an attack here. And they are actually starving for supplies. Oh, well, I guess those are Egyptian soldiers. What do you expect? We could try an attack. I mean, some of our guys are actually looking not too bad now. That's pretty good. Very, very good. Okay, yeah, well, success. Brazil, what are you... Or German Empire? What the heck? What are you guys doing over here? You have the Brazilian flag, but you're the German soldiers. All right, whatever. Good luck, guys. Good luck. Probably still need more guns, right? Yep. Minus 7,700. That's not bad. Cool. Come on. Ooh. Let's see if we can do this. Come back down here. Good. Less resistance, please. Thank you very much. Thank you. Minus... Oh, actually lost a production on that. Minus 7,000 guns needed, though. Nice stuff. I keep throwing them on here because there's too many capital ships. Five? I think that's five. Should be about five, so I need about 20 screens. Oh, you know, let the Egyptian starve over there. That's fine. Eastern Anatolian Railway Network, not bad. Centralized fire control. How about Beirut? Industrial zone, the economic motor of Syria and its primary harbor. The city of Beirut serves as an important role in the industrialization of the Mashriq and also in further centralizing authority. Although some have proposed it, shift focus more to Damascus or Homs. Both established agricultural and manufacturing centers, the government has proven adamant in its focus on Lebanon, supposedly to break the power of Damascus. Very good. Oh, yeah, we have this too. Let's grab some forward observers. Recon gets more recon, which means we should probably get some recon. More support equipment as well. Yeah, the Empire celebrates Eid. Very cool. Very, very good. Thank you for the political power. I appreciate it. Asir is looking pretty much Asiri. Let's do that here. Yeah, I'm going to put down these guys here. How are you guys looking? Because we did put our intelligence officer here as well. Passive defense, why not? Yeah, I think we have civilian factors to do so right now. It's still stuck at 82. Still slightly going up, maybe. Oh, nothing in Beirut. That's good. What about down here? No resistance. Love it. Alright, let's try an attack now. You guys might be able to do okay. Maybe. Can you guys help out? Thank you. And once they have one tile left, that'll be good. We bought about 5,000 guns. Yep, 5,200. 130 a day, not bad. Slowly winning over here because we still have our planes, which is nice. Very, very good. Theater Hospital 2s, that'll be nice once we get them. Let's get some recon since we're going to need to put a recon on a recon. Nice. Oh, those Egyptian soldiers. Once these guys are gone, we'll focus over here, crush these guys, and I will naval invade Persia because they're still researching. Oh. Well, maybe we're not. Hold on. Oh, wait. I thought I researched it already. Maybe I didn't. Mr. Mokulover, what is wrong with you? There's a lot of things. Well, actually, maybe not that many things wrong with me. Just, I am forgetful sometimes. It only takes 2 months, that's all. Better fighters are very nice. Anything else? Fortify Baghdad? We don't really need to. And since we got Baghdad last time, we could do that, but we gotta come down to Hejaz. Oh, actually. Yeah, just Hejaz. Cool. Very good. Very, very good. Less than 4,000 guns needed. So nice. Sina? Not Sinai, maybe, but Sina? Calvert's not looking bad either. Alright, guys, let's see if we can finish this part of the war effort. Actually, you guys are Ottoman irregulars and you're 10 combat width. Oh, those are the soldiers that we conscripted from our other guys. You're 18 combat width, and you guys are actually 12, but you have support artillery, so. Alright, guys, let's see what happens. We could force the attack, but that's not cost too many casualties. Actually, I'm going to put you guys actually on this one, and I'm going to do this. Once we get enough artillery, we'll throw you guys on here. That'll be good. And we're going to cover all our divisions to be like that. So that should be pretty good. And they have nowhere to run, so we've encircled like 15 divisions. Oh, there goes Ivory Coast. Much more important than us taking out Jerusalem, or really, Syria. Wow, they have like no equipment left. Well, like, you kind of figure when they stopped attacking, but whatever. And actually, is Persia... Persia's by itself, that's fine. So we gotta capitulate the Egyptian. Well, we killed a lot of their divisions. Nice. Resistance stuff? Yeah, there's gonna be some resistance here, but... Actually, how's this looking? A little worse. Quite a bit worse for the artillery pieces, actually. It's alright, though. That is okay for now. Alright, not bad, not bad. Passive defense. Form a department if we need to. Beiruti Industrial Zone. And confiscate the privy purse holdings. Although the power of the monarchy has seen a steady decline these past few decades under the supervision of ambitious party figures, the crown is still the direct owner of the vast swaths of the empire and uses these lands for their own benefit and enrichment. That they are depriving the state of resources in a state of crisis should be unacceptable, and they will only fund the religious extremists. Yeah, we'll lose stability, but hopefully we can get some more later on. We actually have 58% stability. Wow, look at that. Ruling party popularity, 0%. I'm not sure about that, but sure. Okay. Not sure we're getting your info. Oh, we are making destroyers. I thought we weren't for some reason. I haven't looked at this at all, have I? Improved subs? I don't mind subbies. Subbies are nice. There you go. If you want to make some subbies, let's go do so. Nice. Guns not looking too bad. Not bad at all. What do we got? Fortify. Yep. Is that it? Not bad. Give some more propaganda, but I think it will be okay. What's over here? Hold on. What was this decision? Oh, yeah. The Fortify Aleppo and stuff like that. Cool. Not bad, then. I could integrate them. We could lower their support, too, down here. Where can I integrate more central authority? It's low. These places are pretty low. So we can't do that because... All the following must be true as autonomous region, integration of Arab Peninsula, that's 70% greater than 50%. Integration of Vilayets, whatever. We can start lowering this as well, unless we want to lower this some more. I'm tempted to lower this area a little bit more, because we can't do anything down here in Yemen, so Mecca? I'll do Mecca first. We love Mecca. So if I do a general attack, it might go okay, it might not go okay. Let's see. If we force the attack, it might do okay. You guys really keep them there, because what we're going to do is cut these guys off in the south. And go right there, maybe. Alright, Calvary, it's your turn to shine as well. Good luck, good luck. Let the infantry spread out, that'll be fine with me. You guys, that's my main goal is just keep them there for now. Try that. And we actually might be able to break through here too, which would be a good thing. If you can force the attack, you'll probably win. And let's not forget about our planes. There you go. Nice. Now that should really help us out quite a bit more. Cut off southern Egypt from the rest of Egypt. Mecca loves us. Oh, we've broken through them. Nice. Oh, a little bit of difficulty around here. That's fine. I think this is the beginning. It already is the beginning of the end. And this is going to be a good thing. Oh, wow. Look at that. Ooh, Two Sicilies is not doing well. The Third International? Well, they're doing okay against the Kingdom of Spain, but... International, I don't know. We'll see what happens regarding them. Senegambia? Well, goodbye, Senegambia. So, I need you guys to focus all up here. I'm gonna leave those other guys like a mess, but that's okay for now. Convoys, eh? If you could force the attack, that'd be pretty cool. Nice. If you guys could beat them up real quick, go up there, actually. So we can circle and destroy that division. And you guys go to Alexandria. Or Alexandria. I don't speak Turkish, obviously. Or Arab. Or Mamluk. Or Egyptian. Or something like that. Yeah. Put them down. Make sure they can't beat us up like that. There you go. Nice. Taking over river is a bad idea, but it is from another tile, so that helps out the combat with. Thank you. Thank you very much. And they're going to die too. Casualties before they capitulate. Not bad. Perch is going to pay, but so is well as Cyprus. Where's the next capital? Oh god, don't tell me it's all the way down here. Aswan. Oh, this is not like Cyprus. Oopsie. I don't see anything else. Put down even more resistance here, probably. Very, very low. I like it. I like it a lot. And you guys are just doing a good job through here, so. Which command power do we get every day? 0.67? That's not great, but that's not bad either. You guys go here to here to here. Al Jagbob. Ah, there we go. You pieces of garbage. Yeah, I'm just taking all states. For now. Cool. Oh, wait. Oh, these guys didn't die. Well, that's alright. It shouldn't be too bad to kill these guys off, right? Now, you guys. This is a lot of territory. I kind of want to hold on to it, though. I don't want to, like, lose it. Ottoman regulars. Oh, we can't convert you guys. That sucks. You guys, though. I think it was you guys. We need a lot more artillery, though. Alright, so we got that more daily political power gain and stuff like that. Ooh, what is this? Oh, we need that S-word region. And we'll try to do that one yesterday, but we can do that one. That's alright. Ooh, naval doctrine. Let's grab this one. Even thus thought about them, the Black Sea is the Persian Gulf. We do, in fact, have a naval base there, and the ability to put a fleet in those waters and beyond. We should take the time to modernize the Basra-Kuwait facilities in case we are needed in the Gulf. Organize a... Ooh, what is this? The Suez Canal. All nations who guarantee the independence of Mustafa-fate of Jerusalem receive access to the reparation effect. Or effort. Decisions which contribute to a shared timer. Straits Convention. The Port Said Straits Convention, with the war both in Europe and other parts of the globe either in full swing or approaching quickly. The status of the Suez Canal can no longer be hesitated about, and there's an immediate need for a binding resolution ratified by all players involved, which will decide its future. Two main options have presented themselves, through the third option, occupation by German Empire, has also been outed by German diplomats. The first option would result in the recreation of international zone around the Suez Canal, now without concessions in Palestine, tasked with the protection and maintenance of this of the canal. This zone, for whom the great powers that be in the Ottoman Empire would be responsible in terms of protection, would be governed as a free state where foreign investors can have free reign, albeit within the limits of the law. The second option preferred by the Ottoman state is the integration of the canal zone into its domain, but with various concessions and restrictions granted to foreign nations. So foreign warships would be allowed to pass in peacetime, never trade never obstructed, even in wartime, and the Suez Company would retain majority shares in the canal. Foreign diplomats have been less open to this plan, however, as they fear this will make the canal reliant on the whims of a struggling nation and potentially greatly endanger their supply lines during times of war. You get stability. No, I don't think so. Commence reparations. Cool. Small reparations. Large reparations. Fate of Egypt. The fate of Assyr. I really don't want to give anyone independence after what they did to us. So, oh, look at that. Die. Die for our amusement. And Syrian insurrection crushed. As the dust settles in Damascus and the last remaining cells are shut down with the assistance of armored cars and the Ottoman armored divisions, it seems that order will soon be restored in Syria. With Ottoman military might dominant once more, it seems unlikely that a second attempt will be undertaken anytime soon. But it might still be undertaken eventually, so keep doing what we're doing. You guys are headed over there to Iran. Let's see, fate of Assyr. Emergency mobilization. Ooh, that's not bad. Ooh, I am tempted. I'm going to do that because we get some free war support. Weekly? That sounds pretty good to me. That sounds pretty darn good to me. I've got to kill those guys off. We've got to still naval invade, but that's fine. Whatever. Another ship. Probably a light destroyer. Thank you. Or just it's a destroyer, not a light destroyer. The cavalry and the tank should do pretty well. Hey, we actually have a positive amount of guns. Finally. Wow, that is unusual for us. That is very unusual. Is there any way for us to integrate, like, Syria? Oh, look at this. Syria. Low, none. Very high, medium. Manan. Well, let's see what happens. Let's do Assyr first. Assimilate into Ottoman territory, its claims on Assyr. The region of Assyr is now under our control. We must decide to do with it. So Assyr is down here. Assimilate. Yeah. I'm not too worried about these guys, because Serenica is not... It's really not that strong at all. Hey, transport ships, finally. They have 2 to 8 divisions. We should be okay down there. And these divisions that we're using currently... Let's go and get some more cavalry on them. That'd probably be good. We could use cavalry, but they're just not as good, I think. So, thank you very much. Grab some of you. Happy 1941, everyone. Hope you're having a good year. And grab some more output, because we could still use more output. Yeah, I don't even have to force attack. We'll be doing pretty darn well anyways. Let's see. You guys come over here. Good. A little bit of lag. Cool. Now, we have plenty of soldiers over here. They still need some more time to get some more supplies. And actually, it looks like we might have some other stuff we could do, too. Once this is done, I will probably navally invade using our camels. Not camels. Other animals called horses. Horses. Yes, horsies. Light tank's not bad. Not great. Infantry is looking... Well, that has looked better. But whatever. You guys can force the attack. Why not? Really just end these guys. I'll cut them off. You're kind of slow, but you're still probably faster than what infantry would give us. Help them out. There you go. No escape for you. Bye-bye. Fate of Egypt, we'll do that soon. I want to do the large reparation effort first. Suez reparation works. Cool. Because we need to get out of here so we can navally invade if we want to over here. Serenicon. Tripolitania? Okay, well, I didn't think we'd be done soon anyway, so. Civil War in Jabal. As various tribes throughout Tripolitania have seen since an opportunity to rid themselves of Ottoman meddling, a civil war has broken up between those still supportive of our regime and those aligned with the Senussi cause, with only the garrisons of Misrata and Tripoli fully reliable. It seems that we've lost control over the almost entire regency. We'll be back. We're not gonna leave. So, y'all made a terrible decision, I would say. You should have done this earlier. We don't even know what's over there, but by Ahmad Faki Hassan. Oh, Hassan, you've made a terrible decision. An unbelievably stupid decision. They have some infantry. I'm going to force you guys to attack as well. I'm not even going to be bothered with this side anymore. I just want to have large reparations. Cool. Expand the Basra Kuwait Axe. Cool. Refit our dreadnoughts. That might not be bad. Engineer schools. Engineer technology. Founded in 1795 under the reign of Selim III, the Muhandishain-e-Bari-e-Humayun serves as one of the most crucial schools in the empire, providing an expansive education in both civil and military engineering. Although the school was temporarily closed during the war as its students joined the army, it has been reopened after the war and expanded with an artillery education in Anatolia. That's kind of cool. You get some free forts, too. And by free forts, I mean it costs 35 days to get, but whatever. Whatever. Oh, look at this. Ah, convoys. Get sunk. Good. Oh, are you guys stalling out or something? That wouldn't be very good. There you go. Go ahead. Come on, guys. Let's go. Vamanos. Actually, I'm going to pull out the tanks because these tanks are looking pretty weak. They probably don't need tanks here, so I'm going to pull you guys out. There you go. Good luck. Probably quite a bit of resistance down there anyways. Oh, it's very high here. Well, if it's already very high, there's no point to not do that then. And then I guess instead of reparations, we'll focus on installing loyal administrators. Go and do that too. Declare martial law. There's no resistance there. How is this area doing? Palestine-ish area. Declare martial law. Nothing there. That's fine. None. Very good. Now, with you guys, could we attack right here and be successful? I hope so, because I don't want Baghdad to be a frontline city anymore. Very good. Nothing else there. Alrighty. And we won there. Nice. Actually, if you really want to, you could press your advantage going that way. And we can actually take some real territory here. And that'd be a great thing. Oh, wow. We have a lot of guns. Thank goodness the enemy's capitulated. Holy cow. Nice. Less than 1,000 artillery pieces needed. Don't mind if we do. Still building. Love it. Horsey boy's doing a pretty good job. We made him 20 combat width. Yeah, you guys can win too. Nice. Very good. Very, very good. Another infantry division, because I will attack here soon enough, so. And what is this place that needs to get lowered? There you go. Surye, or however you pronounce it. Tarabulus. Tarabulus, huh. And that weekly war score going up. Nice. Radio interception group. Grab level 2. Nice. Shippies. Nothing here yet, huh? You're probably gonna level up. Level 3, not yet. Hey, United once more, what is that? Oh, it's over there. A Kievitan restored Sultanate of Is. Oh, I ignored Egypt. Oh, okay. United once more. My bad. So, we got Egyptian integration after we lose daily political power and stability. We get economic turmoil. If you want to read about this, I guess I'll read it anyways. The disaster that befell the Ottoman state in the 19th century, which was only aggravated by the turn of the 20th century, has now been corrected as Istanbul and Cairo are now finally reunited. To prevent this from happening ever again, however, the government has created an extensive reorganization of both parts of the empire, including economic, administrative, and cultural readjustments. Oh, we have Dawn of the Ottoman... Oh, this one too. Look at that. We get more political power, stability, research advances. If you want to read about this one, go right ahead. But we are no longer the sixth man of Europe. We're still sick. Don't get us wrong. Ooh, every owned state unrest will decrease. Lift press restrictions. Ooh, that's not bad either. Repeal this. Varik Varagisi. Ooh, okay. Redraw the vilayets. Will be upgraded. Ooh, look at that. Settle the Sudanese affair. Sudan becomes a puppet. A conference of Alexandria. Yemen becomes a puppet? Oh, that's not cool. Handle the Yemen affair. Economic turmoil. I guess this would be good to go down this route, I suppose. So, redraw the vilayets. Following the examples of Anatolia, an extensive look at the provincial organization of our new lands is essential to ensure proper integration and modernization. Therefore, we need to step away from the old vilayet model and carve it up to smaller, more manageable provinces. How much political power do we not have? Oh, we're not done with our last one yet. Oops. Wait, did we just get a research slot? Okay. My mind must be slipping, because we get 1.2 every day. Oh, stable as a home front. Oh, okay. Cool, we got more stability that way, even though we have minus 4%. Not bad. And how many... we're still doing not bad on factories, considering what we have here. Stability of the realm. We have economic turmoil, unfortunately. We have Egyptian integration effort, which kind of sucks. And the Ottoman Renaissance, which is not bad. I like that one. It's not bad. And we're almost done here. Cool. If you would like to cause... they're necessary casualties, we call them. Oh, we can't kill them off yet. Now lay down your arms, and we'll be pretty good. Nice. Alright, horsies. Your time to shine. Let's see if we can invade from Beirut to right there. And right there. Good luck. We're gonna need it. Enact the Basra Harbor Project. Ooh, we get a building slot, 2 naval bases, a naval dockyard. And basically 4 more coastal forts. Alright, enact the Misrata program. Cool, that looks pretty good. Anything else around here? Small reparations, the fate of Egypt. Army engineer school. Let's do this one. This would be pretty good to do, right? Nice. Let's see, 1.21. I'm looking here if we still have that daily stuff that we got from the end of the last episode. But that's actually pretty good. I don't want to lose that one. Ottoman reinvigoration, good. Hopefully we keep that for the rest of the game, because I still want that output and political power. That would be very... Oh my gosh, that's so many guns. So that's the case. I'm going to do this. We want a few more bombers. Probably want a few more of this. A little bit of lag here and there. There you go. Good. Good. Oh, they federalize. Austria-Hungary. Whoa! Nice job. Deal with Hungary, huh? So they want the Federation of Equals. Looking outwards? That's pretty cool. Oh, that's not good if we end up fighting them, but, that might help lower or reduce lag. Man, French, guys. Paris is a frontline city. I was going to recommend you focus more on the Germans, but I guess you got rid of Spain anyways. I'm surprised that the United States of Greater Austria have not helped out with the Germans yet, but this is kind of ugly. I'll be honest, this is really ugly Hungary. Very ugly. But that's just me. That's just me. It's low. I'm still going to do height this area because it's not very good for us. How many divisions does this group have? I love his clothes, but... Just go ahead. Go whenever you can. They have no divisions. They have one, and it's all in the Aegean Islands. Let's grab the next level, maybe? No, let's grab some more cap. Good, good, good. Instead of more military factories, how do we do this? There you go. Not bad. Tanks are kind of hanging out. Maybe you should not put you there, but I think we'll be okay. We don't have enough stuff there anyways. Let's see. You know what, at this point... You guys are over here. You guys are there. I wonder if we're on the front line. And who is this? Oh, are you guys over here? Oh, you guys are over here. It's fine. There we go. A better solid front line. Now we've got to move around and stuff and be causing kind of some sort of issues. But they attack, they move in. We can still kill them off. I'm not really too worried about it. And how much longer? Oh, there you go. Lycosia. I don't want to invade over here just in case they had more divisions, but hey, whatever. Radio interception group, not bad. Machine assisted decryption, we got it, nice. Ali Sarif Pasha, linguist, a safe cracker. I love his sideburns, but. Cool. Now that should be enough to capitulate these guys, right? Could you guys actually attack here? And force it so this way they have nowhere to run? We tried it with one division before and didn't go so super hot. Oh, hit. Zephyrus is gone. Cool. Before we throw you on the other side, I'm going to throw you guys right here first so we can reform the line some more and throw you into a new army. Nice. Now, the tank's not looking too good, but whatever. And, oh, the Falls of Lisbon. They're international. You're very strong right now. Except for the Russians. Russians not very strong. And, 7 days left. We got a while for that. 70-day focus. Oh, why do you pain me so much? 70 days. The Fall of Paris is gone. Paris has fallen. That's good, but we'll see what happens. You know, Britain, Algeria, of course. God, Africa's a mess, but then again, it's Africa. Oh, they're attacking here, huh? Well, that's not bueno. But they're gonna help out, so I'm not too worried about that. Cool, so let's get our guys back over here and begin doing this. You guys did great naval invading. We got some forward observers. I'm glad we got our tip. It's nice to have a tip. Your own tip, I guess. But, let's see... Forward observers, grab some advanced fire bases. Thank you very much. Over here, fortify, reparations. That's still too much over here for me, for my liking. There you go. And got rid of 83% resistance. Not bad. So many guns. We're doing a little better on artillery, too. We could use some more motorized. Do we not even have motorized? What the heck? Armored cars are actually really good, too. Wait, so... Oh, we added those on, too, huh? We need more steel. Motorized, thank you. Thank you very much. It's quite alright, quite alright. After that, not bad, not bad. How's the line looking? Not great, but not bad. You guys are already over there, which is awesome. And now we should have no enemy ships around here. We shouldn't, but you never know. Come to the Persian Gulf. It's time to teach these guys a lesson. Of course, once we can get over there, though. So. Okay, then. Oh, we could actually... Oh, we have it. Huh. I thought we were still trying to repair it. Then again, it's not that much longer, so. Not bad. Oh, Persia. Persia, Persia, Persia. You made a terrible mistake, Persia. Truly a spectacular mistake, I would say. Regardless, let's see what we got. Our plans over here. Mesopotamia, Sierra Leone. Not bad. Hospitalized Mustafa Kemal. Although our Grand Vizier has reached the zenith of his career, bringing the empire back from the brink of destruction has come at a great physical cost to the man. Years of stress, smoking, and bad drinking habits are generally weighing him down and have led to a steady decrease of time spent in public. Although always remaining stubborn and refusing to re-sign, many of the day-to-day affairs have been behind the scenes, have already been transferred over to his trusted friend Ismet, who seems to set to succeed the line of Antep himself. Whether Ismet will be capable of maintaining the same degree of authority is far less certain. How and had talks with various opposition figures concerning toning down the heavy restrictions are being conducted behind the back of the Grand Vizier. Let's pray for a speedy recovery. I'm gonna put you guys here since you have... yeah, it's fine. Good enough. Do you have any extra spare planes? Not that many spare planes for me to justify putting on another wing. Attacking there would be kind of pointless. We could attack here. It might go okay. What do we have here? Small reparations. It'll be done soon enough. Now, if we had... We're gonna do this and see what happens. Once we can, of course. Of course, our ships can't actually get through there yet. Let's all you guys repair. It's fine. Go ahead and repair. So actually getting this done faster would be probably pretty good. Removes 20 days, only 200 days. More propaganda. Oh, yeah, I want to get it done faster. Nice. Oh, the death. Oh, he died. Holy crap. That's not good. And before we do that, let's not forget this either. And actually, I'll put you guys wherever you need to be. Right there. Cool. So, as the condition deteriorated only further in the next few weeks, many were convinced that the final days of the Grand Vizier were finally upon us. Accepting his own fate, the man summoned a few of his closest friends and his adoptive daughter, Sabaha, and started writing his will. Upon putting his signature below the text, all medical bulletins were stopped in the final hours of the Vizier started to unfold. Flanked at his bed, standing by his secretary, three Turkish doctors and the commander of the guard, he addressed his final words to Dr. Nusret Ömer. Aleykümselam, peace to you, the Muslim replied to the greeting. I thought I read this before. At 9:05 a.m., Ghazi and Grand Vizier Mustafa Kemal Pasha blew out his last breath. His friend Salih later burst into his room, and upon seeing the body of his patron, stepped out and shot himself in the chest. Yeah, I've read this before. I thought I read this before. I guess with... If you want to read this, go right ahead. I thought I read this before, but maybe not. Maybe I've read this in the base game, like Battle for the Bosporus DLC. I can't remember anymore, but... various vessels, both small and large, military and civilian, furthermore sailed in front of the seashore, his seashore villa, shouting, crying, waving the Ottoman flag in memory of the man now forever captivated in the legacy of our grand empire. Furthermore, he also officially nominated Ismet as his successor, referring part of the leadership to Salal. Yeah, so let's speak for the defender of Gelibolu, the line of Antep and the Ghazi of Marassi. Stabilize a home front. Which one is that one? Stabilize the home front. Hold on, let's look it up. Oh, it's already done. Okay, cool. It gets... Move all head of government ideals from the Ottoman Empire. Well, okay then. Alright, well, that's unfortunately passed. Maybe again, maybe not, I don't know, but... Alright. Let's see, where can we make it a strike? I do want a strike. I want to finish Persia off before we end this episode. Not bad. Not bad, they're still pretty strong. But they're really the last little remaining group here, so. Redraw the vilayets, that's good. Lift press restrictions. That would probably be pretty good as well, but let's construct the Hoi4 Cairo Railway. Let's lift press restrictions. As part of the authoritarian measures installed to ensure local total control over the war situation and to smother conservative Islamic resistance to the reforms, the press was heavily curtailed and only commentaries backed by the party were allowed for publication. With the recent pressure on the authoritarian government to liberalize, we should lift the restrictions. Let's see what happens. Alright, you guys looking pretty weak right here. You guys should pretty easily be able to do this. There we go. Get our lands back. Oh, I guess Kaiser Wilhelm II is dead as well. You know what? What if you guys all attacked here? It's probably a bad idea, but whatever. We'll try it anyways. Why not? Could still use more artillery. We've got plenty of guns for now. Artillery's not looking bad either, though. Good. All those ships are docked. Just in case, I'm going to send you guys to Constantia. You never know what could happen. You never know. Oh, they're actually attacking us, huh? Good. Well, good luck with that, guys. You're going to need some luck. Ooh. Attacking over waterways is a really bad idea. They followed Moscow. Wow. Kaiser Wilhelm II dies. Paris is captured earlier, but then they took Moscow? Not bad, guys. Pretty good job. Oh, man. If we could win here, that'd be great. Good. Do you have any upgrades, guys? Maybe? No? More movement speed on land. Or movement bonus on land, I should really say. Basra, there's a lot of waters. Union Brink declared war on Liberia, of all places. Why Liberia? Whatever. Ooh, let's grab some excavation, too. That'd be good. Hey. Why are you attacking me like that? If you guys attack here, could you actually win with some support? Maybe. That's a big river, though. That looks like a pretty huge river. 80? Maybe you might not be able to win, actually. Huh. This would not be bad to attack either, but let's see. Can you get upgrades? Can you actually still... they still might be able to win. Ooh, they're starting to look like they're running out of equipment or something here. Can we see how much equipment they have? 100,000. No, we cannot. Fortify places, now we good. We can, it's still low. None. Nothing. Oh, oh, it's high here. Oh, it's very high here. Well, that's not good. Very high, too. I can't do martial law. It's low in Jordan, which is Oman. Low. Oh, let's do this area first. Actually, which one has more population? This one has more population. There we go. We can centralize authority, but we'll wait a little bit. That's fine. Go, we actually got the territory. Awesome. Awesome, 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 awesome. Oh, but all but one attack there. By all but one, I mean the other one's still attacking regardless. Oh man, I'd love to do a general attack, but probably would not be very smart to do that. Not bad, not bad. I mean, at this point, our army's pretty gosh darn experienced, I would say. Could be wrong about that, but I think we're pretty darn experienced. Let's see, we can throw... Ooh, lift press restrictions, that's good. You guys sally forth. You guys help out, and you guys help out as well. Overwhelming strikes. And construct the Haifa Cairo Railroad. And it's an important axis throughout the entirety of human history. We should improve the connection between the lands of the Tigris and Euphrates and the Nile Delta. Despite earlier attempts to create a direct rail connection, the difference in railway gauges between the Ottoman and the former British network halted all efforts, but no more. Well, in about a month, we'll get some more technology done. That's awesome. Hopefully, we'll win up here. We should be able to win up there. Yeah, it's three divisions. They have forts. I mean, it is a mountain province. That's not really good to attack into. We'll see what happens. They're attacking us, which is fine. Ooh, actually, you guys are over here. You guys support the attack again, maybe? And then you guys maybe attack over here, and you guys support the attack as well? Maybe? Ooh, port strikes? Oh, we're actually doing... Oh. I guess we are, huh? Government cipher schools, machine-assisted encryption. Do some more passive defense we can save on our civilian factories, just a little bit for now. And we almost have enough political power. Let's go ahead and lower this one. It was this one. Nice. It's only medium, not bad. More port strikes? Don't mind if we do, I guess. We are damaging the ships a little bit. Collapse of the Union. Well, hello, combined syndicates. Goodbye. Fall of Nolans. Goodbye. Oh, we're actually not winning here now. Huh. They're about to crack, though. Just like our soldiers. There you go. We've lost 70,000 versus 175,000. 176,000. Not bad. Remy, help out if you can. Ooh, they really don't like that. Oh, now they're attacking on the... Ooh, this is a good time to attack then. 3, 2, 1. Lower their organization. Lower it, lower it, lower it. Begin attacks immediately. And force the attack as well. Do not give them a single inch. You guys actually go this way. Help them out. Attacking over river sucks. But if they attack, and we counterattack, ooh, there goes Finland, we should have some degree of success here. There goes the Reichspact. You guys get in there, you'll be enough to defend. I really want to push through this area if we can. That's my main goal. Casualties are, of course, high, but whatever. A little bit of lag here. Come on, guys. Whoop these Iranians or Persians. God, I wish we get the Suez Canal done faster. Just help them out there, guys. Come on. We're not winning up there, which is fine. Whatever. We're not winning over there, too. So let's go and stop these attacks. Atomic research. Hey, research is done for that. Grab some of this. Not bad. Actually, with 55, we might be able to do pretty darn well. Maybe, maybe not. Especially if you guys help support the attack right here. That might not be bad either. We are making some gains here, which is nice. Go ahead and get you guys centered. Alright, you guys can stop. You guys are failing. You guys... you're probably not going to be successful, but whatever. Try it again. Construction 4. Nice. Get even more extraction. Keep extracting more stuff. That'll be good. And get some planning done. And then if we have one more good push, and then we should be able to destroy them. How much longer must we wait for the Suez? Oh, less than a month. Oh, screw that then. Just spend it now. I want to find the Persian Navy so we can navally invade and then destroy them. Oh, wait, there we go. Oh, minus... What the heck? Oh, completed. Cool. and settle the Sudanese affair. A question of Sudan's future has for a while now bothered the government of Constantinople, as unlike with Egypt, there's very little connection between it and the Ottoman center. The distance further complicates affairs, as any effective communication is basically impossible. Therefore, the idea is now on the table proposing the creation of a separate Sudanese state tightly around, bound to the port. So we lose a lot of this territory, which I really don't want to lose, but it is what it is, whatever. There's nothing I can really do about it. Alright, the canal should be done. We should have our ships moving out. Passive defense is nice. Economy, civilian stuff. Thank you very much. Lost another plane, so be it. And our ship's down here. Not yet. Oh, we got some... these guys going. Can you go now? You should no longer be docked. Let's get going. Come on. Why do I have to manually control you? What the heck? There we go. Hey, we've landed and nearly invaded already. Not bad. And we were smart and invaded around through the ports. You guys go right there. Thank you for playing. Come on, link up, and then we can make one big old central front line. Let's grab even more excavation. More steel, please. Minus 52. Holy crud. Come on, get... oh my gosh. You... why? Bad... it's not bad supply here. It's... level 4 ports, that's not bad. You guys try to go up that way, and the rest of the line, since they're diverting soldiers around, give them a few more seconds, and then we'll do another general attack. We should have them after this one. Assembly line of production, not bad. It's 41. Mars artillery. 3. Oh, look at that, we expanded. Why do you guys take so long, and these guys don't? 2. 1. Go right ahead, see what we can do. We're not going to win everywhere, and that's okay. Just do the best you possibly can. Force the attack, though. Force them down. Force them down. Yeah, we shouldn't really lose here at all. Really? Really, son? Well, with diverting all the soldiers away, the front line here should be... oh, we linked up already with these guys over here. Nice. Yeah, they're done. They are D-U-N. Done. Oh, yeah. I mean, don't get me wrong. We've lost a lot of guys in this campaign. But not nearly as many as these guys have, so. Are you guys... not you guys, who's watching, but my ships. Like, are you really doing anything here? Or do you have found anything? How's that low convoy rating efficiency? 3 task forces. Where are these guys? Why are you... Are you stupid? Yes, they are. These ships are incredibly stupid. You can go through the Suez Canal. It's been repaired. You're already down here. You're just sitting here. For what purpose are you wasting time? You can move over there now. Why did I have to hold their hand? Oh, my goodness. The big dumbs. At least there you go. That's a little better. And you guys are here too. Might as well put an attack. Told the Sudanese affair. Good. And Conference of Alexandria. The current policy of imposed Turkish rule based on our democratic advantage no longer holds true now that the scales have been tipped in the favor of the Arabs. This realization has made many Turkish nationalists redefine the target audience and works toward a more inclusive citizen model. Therefore, the Conference of Alexandria has been opened to finally cement the definition of an Ottoman citizen. Oh boy. Crucial states get liberation? I don't know if I like that. We have made some good gains here in Persia, but my goodness, it is a slaughter between both of our sides. At what cost must we pay to defeat the enemies who declared war upon us? Oh, there goes Venezuela. Good luck, guys. Oh, you guys are medium. No more resistance, please. If you're already very high, I'm just going to do that then. Doesn't matter. But now, if I ever play the Ottomans again, I kind of know what to do with these guys then. So that's good. Persia, I hate Persia so much. You know what we're going to do? I love you, Pasha, but you guys could come over here. One front line. There you go. And everyone else hold for now. Stop attacking. There you go. We lost a lot of guys. They lost a lot of guys, too. So I'm not sure why they caused this war. But we'll make sure that they never cause a war again. And just in case, let's build it up in the port here so we can get some radar onto over here as well. So that'd be good. Let's get some planning as well. That'd be good. 152 army XP. What do we not have enough of? Infantry? No, we had a massive surplus of infantry equipment. That's fake news. That's literal fake news. No. Show me the occupied territories. Egypt? Yeah, I don't think so, man. I don't think so. Now that they have these modifiers? Come on. I wish they did not have this stupid modifier stuff. Or at least give us even more political power with what we're doing right now. That's frustrating. But whatever. Alright, well, we still gotta attack. Give a few more seconds. We have pretty much maxed out planning already, so. Keep attacking. See what type of magic you can make. You guys are actually doing pretty well down there. U4? Oh, we've lost two cavalry divisions. Well, then they're gonna pay for it. They will pay in blood. Yeah, we're racking up casualties, but. Guinean Sindel Republic is gone, huh? Anyone have upgrades? -3300. Oh, whoops, that's the wrong one. Here, let's get some more steel as well. There we go. Actually, you know what? Screw it. Just give me all the steel we need. Wait, excuse me. Come on, game. My bad. That's my fault. I'm just a little flustered, I guess I will say. You know, you usually click on this button to let it tell you how much you need. But sometimes it just... It's a little glitchy. A little glitcherino. Hey, we finally killed something here. Nice. That should help us out a little bit more, maybe. And get some more soft attack. That's good. Come on. They can't have this many soldiers left. They have to have less than 100,000. Because, we're losing a lot of guys, but so are they. Let's go and put down some resistance. Oof. It's low, that's good. It's very high. I'm not too concerned about that. 7.8 million. Yeah, let's do this area first, because that's a lot of resistance for a massive population center. Cameroon is gone. Thank you. Exactly what we need right now. The destruction of Cameroon. Yeah, they're definitely doing not well either. Push them out. Kill them off. They've got to be out of supplies, though. Hey, look, stability. Didn't need stability. Raiders, nice. Ooh, eat again. Don't mind if we do. Grab some of that. Thank you. Oh, no, don't go there. You guys go right there. Mauritania has capitulated. Very good. I know this video's gone for a while, but that's alright. It's fine with me. Like I said, I wanted to capitulate the Persians by the end of this episode, so. Are we still winning? In some places, yes. Some places, no. Tehran is going to be a pain in the booty to get, but they'll fold soon enough. Quarter million we've lost. They've lost 250,000 themselves. All right, let's go and stop these attacks and just go where you need to go for now. You guys, 20 combat width, looking pretty good. Improved artillery, very, very good. I must do this as well. Why not? All right. Massive population here. Put down the resistance. When can we do that? Thank you. And no more resistance. Good. That should save us quite a few guns. Okay, never mind. -13,000. Holy crud. Alright, get our guys around here a little bit more. That'll be okay. Get some guns. Give it some time to calm down a little bit. Armored cars. We're actually making some armored cars. Ooh, you guys. We don't have that many divisions doing this. We could really use field hospitals. I'm going to go ahead and throw on some basic recon. It's going to cost a little bit more equipment, but that's okay. That's what I'm only putting on these guys for now. Alright, so we're going to just manually do it like this then. Because we want to plan for Tehran. Persia. Persia. Why did you start this war? They thought they could win? Well, we obviously proved them wrong. Nice. Give it a few more seconds. Germany's removed from the legation council of the Far East destabilizes further. Oh, okay. Well, whatever. Give them a few more seconds, because we don't want to attack without enough guns yet. 13.84 thousand. That's not good. How much worse does it get? Hey, it's getting a little better. It's mostly from division reinforcement. From new deployments, of course, but mostly from division reinforcement. Even the garrison reinforcement isn't that much. And I just kind of realized, oh wow, we've actually lost so many guys. After we even got even more manpower before, but whatever. So how much more manpower do they have in reserve? I would hate to be in the military. I'd hate to be in our military right now, too. It's been pretty gosh darn bloody. Oh, look, they're still moving out. Alright, this should be the final push that we really need. Especially against Tehran. So, you. Force the attack. We've got to win right now, right here. As soon as these guys are gone, we're going to go up north to attack these guys. 55, come on, come on, come on. Break them, break them, break them. Good, go there. Help them out, help them out. Send only one division. Help them out even more. That's good. Oh, destroy that militia division. 270, we're probably going to lose 300,000 soldiers against Iran itself. But Iran, or Persia, or however you want to call them, or however they would like to be called, are probably Iranians. It's a very mountainous country. It's like Pakistan. I would not want to go to there and try to fight. Oof. Oh, look, an encirclement. Oh, they're dead. As they should be. Good. Come on, take Tehran. Oh, the militia were told to leave. Another cavalry division was told to leave. Take, what was it, the Pasha there? Or not, maybe the Shah? The Shah. Take the Shah captive. Mashhad. Hey, we did it. Well, I guess that's going to conclude today's episode, guys. There might be just one more episode in this campaign. I don't know. We'll see what happens. But that's a nice Ottoman Empire. Do we create our own faction? We have not. And we have the Sudan down here as well. But regards, if you enjoyed today's calmer episode compared to yesterday's, consider leaving a like, subscribe if you're new, check out my Discord link in the description below, and I'll see you tomorrow, when we'll figure out if we might or might not attack the United States of Greater Austria or Bulgaria. Thanks for watching, though, and have a great rest of your day.